crews are working from dusk until dawn. Even if there's no snow in the forecast, the Special Olympics Winter Games must go on.
All my equipment starts to arrive in early December, and then the first week in January, right after New Year's, we assemble the pipe, I get my air compressors, we get the setup for the water, and we just wait for cold weather, and they're here for 24, 36, 72 hours.
We have the only group in the world that makes snow exclusively for a Special Olympics event.
Now this snow, it's all made by volunteers. Some of them, like Vinny, have been doing it for over 20 years. And today, those volunteers are gonna pave the courses for this weekend's events.
And now it's grooming, cutting the courses. When all is said and done, there will be four courses, two for cross-country skiing, two for snowshoeing.
Although this means a few long days and some sleepless nights, 200 athletes are counting on them.
Like I said, the joy that you see from them keeps you coming back year after year, and that's what drives us all. We just enjoy it.
Come this Saturday and Sunday, when the athletes who spend their year, thinking about the games, whether it's the winter or summer games, obviously this is the winter, to have them disappointed is not something that these guys want to, or nor do I want to face.
In Windsor, Allie Warshavsky, Fox 61 News.